honey, one part scotch, and one part distilled fortunes. You will see your luck turn around at but a moment's notice, for better or for worse. Maybe this will stop you from getting the shit kicked out of you so much. I teased as I unclasped the vial and poured its contents into a small silver glass, the gold hue transferring to it and displaying a beautiful shimmer.
Well, maybe then you look like the hot one out of the two of us.
He jeered back, sharing a chuckle as he downed half and passes it to me. I smirked and joined him. A far smaller, puppy-like chowder bounced from the other room and leapt up on Krause's lap, the once goofy boofing sounding now more like small borks, and the drool ever-present as he licked the wounds covering Krause and tried his best to comfort him, Krause laughing the entire time.
Man, if I had a dog like this, I'd take any fucking job I had available.
He chuckled between slobbery kisses from Cheddar. The door to the bar opened again, and a young woman stepped in, early 20s and utterly spellbinding. Her slender figure cut through the noise and the atmosphere of the bar, her red hair flowing down her shoulders and across her chest in an elegant curl, eyes alight with the spark of life. I could not take my eyes off her, and Krause calling me repeatedly dissipated into the ether as she walked up to me, a mixture of confidence and mania written across her face. Welcome to the Spaces Between. I'm Sully, and that little furry fella is Cheddar. The slightly bigger and louder one is Krause. What can I get for you? Her smile immediately faded as soon as I was done with my introduction.
You don't...
She breathed, her soft voice a far cry from the croaky gruffness that I'm accustomed to hearing, courtesy of Krause.
Is everything all right?
I asked, already trying to figure out what kind of drink she may need. Not focusing on the fact her demeanor was rapidly changing.
Sully, my Sully, you've forgotten me already?
Her eyes fell and the smile dropped into a deep, hateful scowl. Cheddar whimpered and leapt down from Krause's lap and ran behind my legs.
Uh-oh, did you break a heart, Sully? It ain't like you, Chief.
Krause chuckled and nursed his wounded, slobber-covered face.
If you don't recall who I am right now, Sully, I'm going to get very upset.
I stared. In all the years I'd ran that bar, I'd never seen her before, and I consider myself incredibly adept at remembering faces, especially someone as beautiful as her.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I don't...
I began, stopping as I watched with a slack jaw what came next. The sound of Cheddar piddling behind me in fear and Krause diving under the table and screaming.
What the fuck?
She screamed, her jaw unclenching and eventually dislocated, showing no signs of slowing down as her facial features began to coalesce and collapse under the pressure of the skin folding over. No tongue or teeth in sight anymore as the jaw stretched back and a smaller head began to peer out of the far reaches of the throat. Gleaming eyes and a horrific voice pushing through the echo of the scream rang out.
I am so deeply disappointed in you, Sovereign. You forgot the promise you made so long ago. You forgot the reasons you took this job. I fell in love with the strongest binding force there is.
It shrugged its shoulders. The hair, and skull, and face sagged back and drooped over the spine.
But I still believe the same is true. The more things change, the more they stay the same.
I couldn't form sentences. I was gripped by a fear I had never known. The kind that slows down your movements as if wading through quicksand. The kind that seems to turn your cohesive thoughts into fractals and your once eloquent speech patterns into terrified stutters. I had seen many strange things in this job, but this took the cake.
Don't worry, I am not here to hurt you. For this was a test, and due to limitations, this wasteful corpse will be disposed of, and you can go about your ignorant existence. But...
It leaned forward, and I could see the faint glint of a smile in the far back of its throat.
I will have a drink before I depart.
I swallowed, my throat dry and my eyes stinging as I realized I hadn't blinked. I shakily turned on my heel and frantically scanned the top shelf of the bar, desperate to find something that would suit this monstrosity's palate. The smallest object caught my eye, and the shape sealed the deal. It was brain, splintered into two segments, one bubbling with gold liquid and the other a grayish substance that fogged over that side of the glass. Taking it down, I looked carefully at the note. The Pilgrim's Choice, for when we need to find our way once again. I sat it down in front of the creature, shaking hands, pouring out the champagne spilling liquid first, then the gray note that fogged over the glass, both coming together to form a brilliant silver concoction that smelled of elderberries. The creature laughed at my nervousness.
Perhaps you should get a drink yourself too, Sovereign. I think you'll need it.
Shit, maybe it was my nerves or the suggestive nature of their voice at the time, but I believed it. I grabbed a bottle from under the bar. It was a special blend I'd been working on myself, and now seemed as good a time as any to try it out. The bottle, in the form of a cracked heart, a blend of herbs and spices, filled my nose as I uncorked it and poured it into a clean glass, the green and yellow liquid bubbling the second it left the bottle.
This is, well, it's called arrhythmia. It's something I've been working on for quite a while now. Well, I don't know what it'll do just yet.
I said, confused at why I was even explaining to this thing. But I suppose professional courtesy wins out every time. I raised the glass and said,
cheers.
We both drank. I mean, I did. This weird fucker simply threw the liquid into its maw, and that's all I could tell you.